人工智能走过60年，在几番沉浮后再度掀起热潮，成为全球科技巨头和资本竞相追逐的宠儿，吹响了第四次工业革命的号角。
And you could argue that the machine intelligence revolution will be as big as either of those two.
Artificial intelligence is a force for increasing inequality.
In Silicon Valley, last year there was more than $500 million investment in AI.
会改变人类社会，这个过程中我们应该有什么样的人文关怀？
从工厂到公路，从律所到医院，机器会夺走人类的工作吗？它将会给世界带来怎样的变化？这场智能革命的浪潮究竟动了谁的奶酪？大量智能化机器加上少量从事管理和维护的工人，奥迪、特斯拉等企业纷纷建起了智能化的无人工厂。这样的生产模式能够提高生产效率，降低成本，节省大量的人力资源。但与此同时，多少人会因此丢掉自己的饭碗呢？
And it disadvantages the people who are made a living through their labor performing those tasks which have been automated.
There's a common theme that people worry that robots will take their jobs, but robots are just going in to backfill where people don't want to work anymore, has been my experience.
ロボットというのは人間の作業をもっと効率よくそして楽にする機械だと考えてください。
Where robots are being deployed are where it's hard to get people to do the jobs. I think we've certainly seen that in China.
比制造业生产方式的革新更甚，人工智能可能会给一些行业带来更彻底的颠覆，譬如汽车驾驶。无人驾驶技术正被谷歌、百度、优步等公司逐步完善，意图给传统的出行方式带来变革。奥迪、奔驰、沃尔沃等老牌汽车厂商也顺应潮流，加紧开发无人驾驶系统，力图保住自己的疆土。不久后的将来，或许人类不用再承担长时间疲劳驾驶的风险，但这也意味着司机这一职业正面临着前所未有的挑战。
There are some areas where a lot of people are employed using skills that we will be able to replace with machines in the near future.And just as previous waves of automation have transformed the labor market, artificial intelligence will do the same thing.